And that bold decision brought them back to France for the filming of an episode that would see the jousting tournament become the turning point for an otherwise arrogant Prince Arthur.
Arthur is quite misunderstood due to the fact that he seems to put on a front quite a lot of the time, which makes him come across as an arrogant prat.
What is that smell? Whose clothes are these?
They're mine. I washed them specially.
The part of Arthur just, you know, really appealed to me because he had so many flaws, but you could see that, you know, there was a reason for those flaws. And he's sort of been through a lot, certainly since Merlin arrived.
Roll, please.
Why did you pull out? I was wide open. You could have unhorsed me.
I was fearful that I might injure you, sir.
You had the advantage. You can't hesitate.
I wouldn't have done if I were facing a different opponent. You are the future king, my lord.
You could almost describe Series 2 as part of a transitional stage for him, because he's clearly changing, and he's not what he was.
It doesn't matter who I am.
I do not expect any special treatment from you, from any of you.
This story is how Arthur learns a little bit more about life.
Is that understood?
And there's a princely price on his royal head.
He is here.
As is common occurrence in Camelot, someone wants Arthur dead. This time it comes in the form of Myror, played by Adrian Lester.
A cold-blooded assassin.
Wherever I seem to go, I seem to be followed by some guy. If you don't see me ever again, it was him.
He's great. He's very menacing in the role of Myror. I think we've seen him in a lot of things before where he's quite a nice, friendly guy, and I think this is something where you'll see a different side of Mr. Lester.
So, how are you enjoying filming?
Yeah, I was just eating lunch on my own and enjoying it. It's a
bit of a loner, really, aren't you?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes I'll, you know, just like my own space and just to, like...
Yeah. Whoa, where'd he come from?
Thankfully, a brave Bradley survived lunch, and filming the episode's epic jousting scenes could continue.
He was French, and I said to him the day after, I said, are you all right, mate? Yeah, you took a bit of a hit there. You know, some real method acting, like tried to like lighten him up with a joke, and he went, don't laugh. And I went, okay, yeah, no problem.